Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at using the Faces feature in Photos. So I'm here in El Capitan and I'm using Photos version 1.2 and I've imported some clip art photos showing some people in them. Now let's see how we add faces to these. And it makes it really easy. There isn't a particular thing you need to do. You just go and look at the photo and you'll see that faces are automatically recognized, but it doesn't know who they are, so it just puts a name under them. And also gives you these circles around them so you see exactly what the Photos app is looking at. So let's go ahead and just name this guy. We'll just name him Guy. And we'll hit return there. And if we go to the next photo, we see right now it thinks, well, hey, this seems to be the same guy. So is it Guy? And I have the ability to say no, it's not, or yes, it is. And now I can go through others, and if that person appears somewhere else, they'll also be added there. So let's go and add somebody else here. Let's go ahead and add Gus here. So now if we go to the next photo here, we can see there's Gus again, but it hasn't identified him. It only has that one image to go on, so it's not enough information for it to pick him out here. So I just start typing again, and I only need to type a few letters and I can now pick from the list, and even shows me a little picture there what I'm doing. And now Gus is identified here, and also if I go back there. So, and this will make it better for identifying this person in the future, in future photos, because it has more information. So basically you start off kind of rough adding the same people a few times, and then it gets better and better at picking out people. So here I've added another face right here, and I'm going to see if it's identified it anywhere else. And I go forward and I see it hasn't here, so I'll give it this one. And if I go to this photo here, not only has it identified this face, but it doesn't even know it's a face because, of course, the kid is upside down. So how can I manually add it? Well, I can go to Info here and I could add faces. And once I do that, it basically creates this circle here that's just in the middle of nowhere. And I can resize it, move it around, and now I can add the name there. So I can do that, and now if I were to look, click away there, I can see the faces are assigned here. So I can go back to these other photos there and I could see that I've got that same kid added here and here. I can also get rid of a face if I want, say, if somebody's in the photo that I don't know, like this happens a lot when you take crowd photos. You take a picture of somebody and there's other people standing behind them you don't know. You can use this X button here to get rid of that face. So it's pretty easy to do. You can also click here and it will take you to the list of all the places where that person appears. So it's there. You can also go into Faces here under Albums and will show you all the faces you've identified in any photos, and you can go into that and see all those photos from that one person. You can go to just showing either the photos or the faces, which is really good, I find, for finding, say, things to use as your profile pic in Facebook or Twitter or something like that. Is you can look yourself up, go there, and then you can find a really good shot of yourself and then go to that particular photo and crop it around there and use that. Now I love the fact that you can then search with names of faces. So I can search for a guy and it shows me there's two results there and I can jump right to it. But better still, I've gone in here and I've also named this woman right here and I've put her, named her in these two photos. So now when I go and do a search, I can search for both names like that. And you can see it comes up with the same two photos since they're in both. But this is really useful, like for instance for an anniversary, you want to find pictures of yourself and your spouse. You can search for pictures that have both of you in them and maybe quickly find something nice to post. So those are the basics, but what if you have a ton of photos and you're just getting started with adding faces to them? Well, if you go to Faces here, you can see these faces that I've tagged so far, but also you see suggested faces here at the bottom. So you can select a face and add that name and it shows you that one photo was added by you and one was added automatically. So now I can find out which one's added automatically. I can go in there and I can view these photos here and check to make sure that it was added correctly. So it did add correctly there. I can go back to faces and continue to do that, to go in and take care of these suggested faces here. I can also control click on one and say ignore this face. Again, useful for when you capture people that are in a crowd or standing behind people you know. You can just say, okay, forget about that one. And I'll remove that one from that photo so you don't have to bother with it again. So basically, your goal if you want to have everything set for faces in your photos collection is to go through all of these until they're all cleared out. Either you've assigned a face name to them or you've set them to ignore, and then you have all your faces up here. You can easily access them, you can search them, and you can just view them as an album. And then of course if you're using the iCloud Photo Library, this will translate to all of your devices.